Hey guys, welcome back to the channel and a very good day to you all. In this video we will see what is the banking of roads. So first of all, before starting off with the derivation, we will see what is banking of roads and why there is a need for banking of roads. So suppose consider this curved path, which is a section of a circle, and there might be a center or somewhere over here. So now when a vehicle wants to take a turn on this curved road, it actually wants to move in this direction, but due to the lack of friction and over speed, what will happen is that instead of moving in this curved direction, the vehicle will tend to deviate from its path and it will move in this direction, that is away from the road. So there is a huge possibility of accident. And to avoid this possibility of accident, what we actually do is that we tilt the road in a type of a slope. That is, we raise the height of the road from the outer side towards the circle. So we raise the height of the road somewhat in this manner. Suppose this is the center, which is this center over here, and we raise the outer side of the road. So what will happen now is that when the vehicle is tilted, it will automatically move in a circular manner instead of getting deviated from the path. So this is our vehicle which we are considering in the form of a block. Let's start with the derivation. So for the derivation, there are many forces which we need to resolve. Okay, one force which acts on each and every individual body is nothing but its own weight, and the component of force of weight always acts vertically downwards. No matter whatever might be the body, the force component will always act in a vertically downwards manner. So this is our force weight component. Okay, now the formula for weight is nothing but mg. Therefore we write over here as mg. And now there is always one force acting away from the body and perpendicular to it. That is nothing but the normal force. So this is our normal force and it is represented by N. Remember guys, the normal force is not perpendicular to the ground, but it is perpendicular to the top surface of the body. Okay. Now there is one more force acting in this scenario, that is the friction of the road, and this friction will be acting towards the road, which is trying to hold the body towards the center and not allowing it to deviate from its path. And now we will resolve these forces. For resolving the forces, we need the value of theta. So this is our theta, that is the angle with which the road is being tilted. So I will resolve this frictional force into two components, that is the horizontal component and the another one is the vertical component. Okay, now the components of this frictional force will be F cos theta and F sin theta, but we don't know which is the F cos theta and which is the F sin theta. So for that we will have to take this angle to be theta, because alternate angles, okay, we have done this property in 9th standard. This angle and this angle are alternate angles, therefore this angle will be equal to theta. So now the force which is having a theta closer to it will be nothing but equals to F cos theta, and the force which is not having theta closer to it will be nothing but equals to F sin theta. Let's draw the components of this normal force also. So there is one horizontal component and there is one vertical component. Now if this angle is theta, this vertical will make an angle of theta with the perpendicular. So this angle will be theta. This angle and this angle will be equal. Now we all know that the component having theta will be N cos theta, and the component not having theta will be n sine theta. So now in total we will consider this weight which is acting vertically downwards. Since we have resolved this normal force into two components, therefore the main normal force will not be considered. So there is one n cos theta which is acting upwards, n sin theta which is acting in the leftward direction, f cos theta which is again acting in the leftward direction, and the f sin theta which is acting in the downward direction. Again over here we have divided the fs into two components, therefore we will not be considering this main frictional force. Now along y-axis, that is along the vertical direction, y-axis is always in this direction, that is the vertical direction we are considering. If you see the horizontal force, the downward forces will be equals to upward forces. So the downward forces will be equals to upward forces. So what all are the downward forces over here? We can see is that this mg is downwards. And is there any fs sin theta is also downwards, plus fs sin theta. And is there any other downward force acting on this body? No. Therefore we will write equals to, and there is one upward force, that is the n cos theta. So this is the first equation which we have got, is that n cos theta is nothing but equals to mg plus fs sin theta. From here we will just move fs sin theta to the right hand side. So mg is nothing but equals to n cos theta minus fs sin theta. We will name this as number 1. Now in the previous module of the chapter we have seen that centripetal force. What is centripetal force? Centripetal force is nothing but the force which holds the body towards it. And now since it is the, this is the center is somewhere over in this leftward direction, the body is being held in the leftward direction and it is not allowed to move away from the path. So which all the forces are acting in the leftward direction will be due to the centripetal force. So centripetal force is nothing but equals to the all the leftward acting components. So which all forces are acting leftward direction is that n sin theta plus fs cos theta. And now the formula for centripetal force is nothing but mv square upon r, where m is the mass of the body, v is the velocity of the body, and r is the radius of this circle, okay, is equals to ns n sin theta plus fs cos theta. So now we will name this to be again 2. Over here we will divide 2 by 1. After dividing the second equation by first equation, we will get what is that v square upon rg is nothing but equals to n sin theta f cos theta upon n cos theta minus fs sin theta. You all can check if you all want to, but I am not solving these baby steps. I am directly writing the equation. After dividing the second equation by first equation, you will get this equation, okay. So now from this equation we will see that v square is nothing but equals to, taking rg on the right hand side, rg into this whole same as it is, I will write it over here, okay. n sine theta plus f cos theta upon n cos theta minus fs sine theta. Okay, now taking square root on both the sides, we will get v is nothing but equals to under root of rg into n sin theta plus f cos theta upon n cos theta minus fs sin theta. And this formula of velocity which we have got is nothing but the maximum velocity with which the vehicle can travel with on this banked road. If the vehicle exceeds this speed, then what will happen is that the vehicle will deviate from its path and there is a chance of an accident. So from this formula we can calculate the maximum velocity with which a vehicle can travel on this banked road. Suppose now the friction over here is zero. Before considering the friction to be zero, we will consider another case that suppose the road is not banked. So since the road is not banked, there will be no rise in the height from the outer side, and the road will be plane, and therefore the theta will be zero. So now over here we will further on simplify this equation. So we know the formula for friction is nothing but mu into n. Okay, so now instead of friction fs over here, I will write mu n. Okay, now this vm will be nothing but equals to n sin theta plus mu n cos theta upon n cos theta minus fs sin theta, mu n sin theta. Okay, now over here I will take n common, so vm is nothing but equals to rg into n from the numerator and n from the denominator, and what we will left out will be with sin theta plus cos theta upon cos theta minus sin theta. So this n and n will get cancelled. Now what I will do in the further step is that I will divide the numerator as well as the denominator over here with cos theta. Since you are dividing the numerator with cos theta, you also have to divide the numerator with sin theta, and there here we are having a multiplication sign, therefore we can apply this method which we want to. So vm will be now equals to under root of rg into sin theta upon cos theta plus cos theta upon cos theta upon cos theta, sorry, we are left out with mu also over here, mu minus mu sin theta upon cos theta. Okay, so now sin theta upon cos theta will give us tan theta. Okay, the vm will now become under root of rg into tan theta plus mu cos theta upon cos theta will be equals to 1 upon cos theta upon cos theta again 1 minus mu sin theta upon cos theta is nothing but tan theta. Okay, so this is the formula for velocity which we have simplified from here on. And now if we consider the one more case, that is if the road is not banked. So road is not banked, then the theta will be equals to 0. So when theta equals to 0, tan 0 is 0, The equation with which we will be left out is that Rg mu, okay, this is the equation which we will get for the maximum velocity. So guys, thanks for watching the video. Please do like the video, share with your friends, and do subscribe to the channel.